All right, here we are at the workbench. Our barrel's drilled up. You can see where the hole passes through the front sight block. You can also see that it intersects the barrel. Looking at it this way, you can see our alignment marks are still matched up. It's perfectly aligned. I don't have to worry about trying to clean those holes up. What I'm going to do right now is, with our drill bit shank still in place and our clamp on it, I'm going to take our tapered reamer that we have with our kit, and on the right hand side of the barrel assembly I'm going to start reaming this hole right here. But before I do that, to make sure everything's perfect, what we're going to do is take it back off. We'll put the gas tube on to make sure there is absolutely no difference between this and the spacer I made. And then we'll go ahead and ream that hole after we put our drill bit shank back in. And we'll tap our pin in and we'll ream the forward hole. Let's take it apart right now and we'll see what we've got. And this drill bit shank is really in there nice and snug, which is a good thing. Alright, now that's a number 30 drill bit shank I shoved in that hole, and we drilled it with a number 30 drill bit. Alright, you see how our barrel pins, or our front sight block pins rather, pass through the barrel. Alright, now I'll remove our spacer washer, clean it off, clean any debris off the front sight. Put our front sight in place. It looks like it's about right. Our holes line up real nice. Alright, put our drill bit shank in there. Alright, very nice. Now we'll go ahead and get this reamed in place. I'll ream the rear hole, tap our pin in, and then we'll ream the front hole. And again, we ream it from the right side. The tapered pins are installed from the right to the left, removed from the left to the right. Okay. Alright, I've got my drill bit in our front hole. I've clamped the vice grips on that front sight just to make sure it's secure. And I'm going to start turning our tapered pin reamer. It's a good idea to use cutting fluid on it as well. Alright, I'm going to take our taper pins out of our bag here. Alright, see how far that pin goes in there? Got a good bit more to go. I want to keep the top of the pin about a 16th of an inch or so, to 3/32 of an inch. From being flush with the surface of the sight block right there. You want to keep checking this regularly. I know exactly approximately how deep to go with this pin reamer. If this is the first time you're reaming one of these holes, you want to check it regularly, because I tell you what, it'll sneak up on you real fast when it's done. I mean, it seems like it doesn't go a whole lot, and then all of a sudden, next thing you know, the hole's finished. Your pin is right where it needs to be. Always have a couple punches on hand to make pin removal and installation easy. And you know, this is basically a video I want to show you just how much work is involved in this. This is how I'm doing it, more than how to do it. By watching me do it, you can see just what work is involved. Alright. There's still a good bit of pin sticking up out of that hole. I'm going to go ahead and tap it and see just how difficult it is to tap that in place right now. Almost in place. It's almost flush with the surface of our gas block, or our sight block rather. I'm thinking AK here. It's almost flush with the surface of our sight block. All right, it's almost flush back here. A couple more taps and it'll be good. Alright, that's good. Now we're going to go ahead and ream the front one. You saw just how much we had sticking up, and we'll ream that front one there. It's pretty close right there. The reamer is in pretty much the same depth that it was in the back part of the back part of the sight block. Alright, looks like I need to go a little bit deeper on that. Let's tap it back out and we'll ream it some more. Alright, let's go one a hair more with that. Almost there. Okay, that was really not a lot. Okay, taper pins installed. And that's how I install the sight block on an AR-15 barrel, virgin barrel. Alright, let's go ahead and take a look at our pins now that they've been installed. That's the small side. Alright, there's the large side. Alright, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't too difficult with the equipment I have here in the shop. This came out, I think this will be a good video. It shows you exactly how much work's involved and what it's going to take to get your front sight on here. I really don't know anything about, really not a lot about AR-15s. So doing this particular job is new to me. I know a lot more about AKs, and I was able to use some of the principles I've used in building AKs to do this work. Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoyed this video, because I tell you what, it'll help you get notifications in the future when I upload other gunsmithing videos, you'll get notified on that. And if you enjoyed the video, go ahead and click like if you found it helpful. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Like I said, if you subscribe and stay tuned, you'll see upcoming videos. Don't forget to, also, if you need more tips, you can look at my past ones on building AKs. I built a PSL. Take a look at my video on building or making the 26.5 millimeter smoke rounds for my flare launcher. Show you how to make the compound and how to make the smoke cartridges. We also shoot at the end of the video. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. I really appreciate all my subscribers, and I'll try to keep you updated and informed on new things as I learn them. If you have any questions about other topics that perhaps I know about that I haven't done a video on and you want to know about it, give me a shout and I'll see if I can't get a video for you on how to do that particular thing. Alright, thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful.